So you need some things to check your skin properly. You need a well-lit area. Usually standing by an open window might help, but you might not want to expose yourself to your neighbors. So just make sure you have a well-lit bathroom or bedroom. And then you need a handheld mirror, as well as a regular mirror. A couple of chairs would be nice, a hairdryer if possible, and a stool. So depending on your dermatologist, you may need to check your skin every 3 months, or even as infrequently as every year or every 2 years. How we're going to check our skin is just find a consistent method to check it on your body. So let's start with the head first. You need to check your scalp. It's easier if your hair is wet. It's easier to part. Sometimes if you forget that point, you could always use a hairdryer at a cold setting to take a look at all the little parts. Sometimes you can't see the sides or even the back, so this is very important to find a friend, a partner, a parent, sibling, someone to help you check as well. So when you're checking the front of your body, you can look down. You can use a mirror as well to help you out. You're looking at your skin, at the shoulder areas, the neck area, as well as the armpits, the side of your body, your chest, under your breast, and also the genital area. So let's check the back part of the body. What you would do is stand facing away from the mirror, use the handheld, and look at the back of your body. So you'd look at the back of your neck, your shoulders, your lower back, and then your buttocks. If this is really difficult to do and really difficult to view in a handheld mirror, then you can ask a family member or a friend to help you check these areas. So looking at your arms, you would look down and check out your shoulder areas, your arms, elbows, forearms, down to your hands. You can look down and check your arms this way, to the front of your arms here. You can spread your hands open and look at the palms and the back of the hands. You can also look at your fingers and in between the web spaces just to make sure that there's nothing there. So when you're looking at your legs, you can sit down and you can look at each leg individually. You can bend your legs and then look at the inner part of your thighs. You look at your knee, your leg, and this is a great way to look at your ankle and at the bottom of your feet. Same thing, you can bend your leg this way to look. You could also use a mirror to look at the front of your legs. If you want to look at the bottom of your sole, what might help if you're not able to see it is use the handheld mirror again and take a look at the bottom. Please don't forget to check in between your toes. So if there are any moles or funny looking spots that you're concerned about, sometimes it's really hard to remember. So the best way is actually taking a picture of that mole. What's helpful is actually using a ruler and you place it beside the mole. And then when you take the picture, you could actually show it to your family doctor and just show them what the changes are.